These are two local girls, Maria Jose from Trafalgar Square in Yefa, Badalona, and Nuria from Sagrera, well, almost Verneda, where the Pont del Treball is. Today they are looking for a North American friend. Why? Every year, private US industry lobbies, the so-called International Intellectual Property Alliance, exert an invasive pressure on the Spanish executive through their special 301 report on countries that require special surveillance because of their disobedience to the interests of Hollywood entertainment multinationals. This report names Spain as one of its top offenders and stigmatizes the whole of Spanish society as pirates, when in fact the country has valuable legislation that allows sharing among peers for non-profit purposes. The same report contains other ridiculous claims, like the fact that Thailand has to be monitored because it promotes open source programs. But that's beside the point here today. We're in Barcelona. So the government got scared, and in order to appease the North Americans, it rushed to promote nonsensical laws like the first final provision of the Law of Sustainable Economy. This is serious for the following reasons. One, as reflected in a report by Consumer International, US policy has double standards in this sense. In their own territory, they themselves do not apply the rigor that they demand of their allies, given that the provision for fair use in US legislation allows many more exceptions to copyright than those allowed for in European legislations. Two, the Made in the USA entertainment industry lobbies in favor of Report 301 in order to defend its own market. Spain is not a partner in this sense, only a market. But the interests of the Spanish cultural industry are precisely to bring to an end the monopoly of the US industry and balance the market share. Okay then, so what exactly happened? While they embark on their search, we'll continue our story. When the Spanish president, in response to popular lobbying, wanted to modify the first final provision of the Law of Sustainable Economy so as to make it more respectful of fundamental rights, the US ambassador immediately scolded him. Following this, we wrote to the ambassador in order to see him and explain the situation. It's normal that he would be loyal to his own industry, but that doesn't mean going and ruining another country's economy and culture. So that was 4 months ago, and no matter how often we ring him to line up an appointment, we still haven't managed to get through. We understand that this is because we're not US citizens, and the ambassador is beholden to his people. So we are looking for a North American friend who can help us contact the ambassador so we can explain the problems of Report 301 to him.